Skullface. So he was in Africa after all. Working behind the scenes, even that man on fire at his beck and call. But what the hell was going on at the Devil's House? Earphones embedded in people's throats, tapes playing voices. And those lumps on their chests, they looked like the ones on the bodies of the oil field. The man on fire burned everything to the ground. But we were recording audio the whole time you were there. We'll conduct a thorough analysis of it.
Good. We captured it alive.
Skullface is working through PFs in the region. Anyway, it just so happens a job connected to this inspection has come in. Take a look at your iDroid.
Boss, if you need combat support, just let us know.
About those invalids you saw in that Devil's House.
Poor bastards. All strapped down to the beds, with those lumps on their chest.
The medical staff tell me they were probably a type of cyst.
Cysts can get that big?
In some cases, yes. But supposing they're a kind of atheroma forming on the surface of the skin, the size is just too big, and the appearance is all wrong. In the end, the medical team were at a loss. Those lumps were like nothing they'd ever seen. The fluid you said you got on your prosthesis when you touched one was burned off in the fighting, and the factory burned down too. None of the tests we did once you were back at the base revealed a pathogen that could have caused them. Meaning we don't have a single sample to work with.
Everything went up in flames.
What worries the medical team most is whether it's contagious. Whether there's a chance we could end up like that.
And?
Mother Base's sanitation control has always been strict. After all, war is great at transporting diseases. For the time being, at least, there's no sign of contagion or any symptoms that could be related. One more thing. About the surgery that had been performed on the people in the Devil's House.
Yeah.
You said that their throats were cut open. With an acoustic tube pushed inside?
Right. The tubes were hooked up to tape recorders, playing some kind of audio.
Well, we picked up some of that audio through your radio transmissions and recorded it here. The intel team has been working on analyzing the communications log.
What have they found?
There's nothing tying the contents together. We've got a report on 3 deaths in a car accident on the auto route near Marseille. Protests outside the Libyan embassy in London. A press conference with the former Prime Minister of Sweden. A 4-month-old weather forecast for Balikpapan. And then commercials for appliances, cough syrup, and TV dinners. Assuming they're not all staged, they come off as recordings of your average public broadcasts.
Public broadcasts? Just radio and TV signals?
Yes. And from all over the world.
I'm ready for dispatch.
We're looking into whether they're genuine or not, just to be sure. What else? A speech that sounds like it was recorded out on the street, and people chatting about how this year's tomato crop did.
And there's nothing they have in common?
We're partway through the crypt analysis. That includes checking all audio ranges and running it backward and at different speeds. Then there's vocabulary breakdown for political suggestions, ideological common points. But I don't think it's gonna get us anywhere.
Where were the recordings made?
There's nothing linking them from that angle either. Just like you reported, we've detected virtually every major language there is. French, German, Italian, Spanish, including South American accents. Then there's Russian, Hindi, Arabic, Portuguese, Mandarin, Cantonese, Japanese.
They're nothing if not thorough.
Well, I don't know if we've got them all covered. Ignoring the ones that have gone extinct, supposedly over 5,000 languages exist today. Besides, English isn't one of the ones we picked up.
Really? English?
I know. Only 5% of the world's population is a native English speaker. But when you factor in those who've acquired it as a second language, nearly 1/3 of the people speak it. The world's dominant lingua franca. You gotta figure they had it somewhere among all the languages in that place.
No English.
Bear in mind, we didn't hear everything that was played in that room. We couldn't isolate the more distant sounds due to static and the... Well, the program could have been set to change every day.
We really need some more room.
In a nutshell, for reasons unknown, people in that room with a common medical condition were made to listen to recordings in languages from around the world. It's not clear how the growths on their chests fit into it. It could have been treatment for them, or maybe an experiment of some kind.
I'm guessing one person knows.
Yeah, Skullface. He was there. The only thing we can say for sure is that he's involved.
Roger.
This is B-Quad. Arriving shortly at LZ-1.